time. Story time. And they like to sing me songs once in a while. I love songs. Especially when it's story time. So don't forget to grab all your little friends. Don't leave anybody out. It's not nice. Even this little brother guy. See? There you go. He's the guy that I love to tickle. Well, I better put these guys to bed because he's getting tired. So we got to kiss them all goodbye. Give them the hug. Give them the squeezies. Yeah. So love from love. Hope from hope. Peace from peace. Oh, I'm just going to give them inwards, my little. Guess what? It's time to ring the bell. Because this is the time for a blessing of Kingdom Age time. And, beloved, I can't thank you enough for coming, and you won't be disappointed. So let's play some music. The blessing of Kenny G. And know this, we've been looking through a glass darkly, knowing only in part, only seeing in part. The Lord has veiled the ripped the veil. And because he has ripped the veil, we can turn on the lights and we can see better than we have ever before. The wise will be able to shine as the stars because he has come giving his kingdom age new covenant to all mankind exactly as it is written. And now I'm losing my little flashlight. Aha! Good for story time for spooky stories. But this is not a spooky story. This is a good story about God's love for one and all of us. One people. One God over all. And that is what is written in the word of love. So get ready. And know this. This used to be dead wood. This paper. But now, what is it? It is living inspiration. So as I get going here, know this, that all the proud and the arrogant of religion won't have any root or branch to hold on to once I come forth with this. I just realized I got to have my little glasses too, because I'm an old guy. Do I have my glasses? Or maybe I could see. Nah, I better get my glasses. I better get my glasses. Close. There we go. Well, story time. Get ready, get set. And if you like this, like it. Comment. The only thing I'm getting in my comments, in my channel is some porn keeps hacking my comment section. I don't even know where in the heck that's coming from. But I do know one thing for sure. God is good and he arises over all crud and he wipes it all away. And so hello and here we go. I'm a poet and I didn't even know it. The word of Jehovah Nissi, the banner of love over all of us, came unto me and said, Daniel, mine anointed Elijah, you are my foretold Shiloh of all of my kingdom's authority. And unto you alone my scepter of love has left Judah and come into your hand of my power overflowing from my spirit of prophecy, the revelation of my Lamb's overflowing love for all of those committing not the unforgivable sin of letting their light of love to go out. And so then our Lord God Almighty said unto me, he said, let the world view my love through the blinding light of my two candlesticks of my greatest glory, Trudy and Daniel, brother and sister from Windsor, Ontario. Only then may the wise come to see that before his removal, the devil always wanted to consume all men like a fire which rages in stubble, and he wanted to swallow them like water. And by And by his banishment, the Lord says, my most merciful beneficence goes before me as my most loving glory, so all people of my love might be saved from his horrors unleashed. His time was cut short because the first is last and the last is first. And that was one of the last happenings in the religion of man. But in God's book, it was always scheduled to be one of the first because of that. Just as the seventh trumpet sounded first in the book of Revelation because it was last. And we are last, created last, because we are first. We are the Lord's most magnificent creation of all, whose glory of the latter house is greater than that of the former host. That's why Satan was always so angry and jealous over mankind. So then our Lord stressed that his Son of Love now arises over all flesh, desiring his kingdom age peace. So thus saith the Lord God, I have prepared thrones and crowns in heaven for all obeying my prophetic word of Habakkuk 2. To King James, for the wheat of my love must leave the tares, they must leave the tares of disobedience to his prophecy being manifested. New living wine does my two candlesticks now serve upon my holy mountain of Isaiah 25 for the marriage supper of the Lamb of the book of Revelation, so that all shame may be removed from all people of my kingdom age faith herein, and all of those heeding my latter day Daniel of Daniel 12:13, who I am, shall all receive my mark of my Lamb 777 upon their foreheads, as I seal their heart of hearts. Neither will Morg, the revealed son of lawlessness, prevail over them, says the Lord, as they ascend unto their good shepherd's great white cloud to stand with him as his angels of love, his mangels, who are as gods. That's what he said. We are as gods, John 10, as he said. And all people of love shall now blaze a fiery path of passionate action as they resign from the walking dead of a people of do-nothing faith. So let the evil let not the evil of ignorance inflame the wise desiring to shine as the stars that I created them to be, says our beloved. And then Adonai Elohim Allah, then he lovingly said this. He said, so let the wise understand that if people are double-minded in their prayers, they become darkness. They become darkness unto themselves. And we don't want to, there's enough darkness in the world. We don't want to become darkness to ourselves. So then the Lord asked me, Daniel of Isaiah 41's north, predicted to come from the north, and Trudy from the north too. He asked me what I wanted to add, since I am his messenger of his very best good news that has finally come at last. And he always saves the very best for last. So after a moment of inspiration, his spirit then led me to say, as Shiloh of Genesis 49:12, same guy as the latter-day Daniel. He says, let people believe, this is what I would say, let people believe the truth that the Lord has called a fool, and I can call myself a fool. That's politically correct in my book, because I've been a good fool. He's called a fool to confound the wise, and as his Elijah, Malachi 4:6, he has brought forth one that has been rejected by his whole family and his wife and all of his friends, because no one wants nothing to do with a man so passionate about love. And so I'm a failure in the realm of love, and he's called me to help strengthen all other families ravaged by loveless families, because the hearts of everyone has to turn to one another, and I'm the right guy to help bring that to pass. So vote for me. Me versus Biden. What do you think? That would be good. Next race. Forget Trump. He'll let him stay in Israel because he's the branch that has grown into Jerusalem. His head is on the third temple coin of the Sanhedrin for a very good reason. And as the Lord's latter-day Daniel of Daniel 12:13's manifested prophecy, who would arise in the latter day, latter-day Daniel, the Lord has brought me forth in the spirit of Daniel of the lion's den to have all understanding of all spiritual mysteries that have now been revealed unto all who really want to know, who will press in to these videos of education. And if people of love hear not the Lord's foretold message through his prophesied everlasting gospel herein of Revelation 14, says the Lord's spirit of prophecy, then it would come to pass that things will get so terrifyingly bad that multitudes would end up wanting to die even though their own hatred can never be killed as they walk the roads of perdition and the roads of lovelessness leading to the unforgivable sin and are perishing by letting the Lord's light of love to go out from our midst, because that is our everlasting light for our next angelic bodies made of the love of God. But the wise will see that a slave of our King of Peace, Emmanuel, has now been raised up from the north, as Isaiah 41 said, in Canada. And the influence of love through Trudy Darlene and Daniel Fletcher shall be as mortar upon the leaders of the world as love changes this planet all around and brings forth a world of released peace and love and harmony. And that is what is predicted for the kingdom age, and that is what is arising in the midst of multitudes and multitudes of ignorant people in the valley of disobedience, who rejecting this word by doing nothing about it. And as our Prince of Peace's slave of Isaiah 49, that is where I was predicted, and that is where a man 30 years ago, a prophet, said, here you are, right here, Daniel, that's you. And I shall evermore be passing on his loving message, his message, unto all obedient brethren that can receive a message from heaven still, that makes all faith before it obsolete, because the kingdom age covenant has been given, as Hebrews 8 foretold, and that is what Paul said would happen. When that happened, all faith would be obsolete that was before the kingdom age covenant of Chrislam, the name that God has chosen for Israel once they get their kingdom age covenant, Isaiah 62:2 foretold their new name. And he alone is our risen majesty of majesties of kingdom age harmony, if anyone will pay attention to his word. Thus saith Daniel, the second candlestick of love after Trudy. Our lion of Zion is roaring, peace be still. Who will not listen? For the most holy name of God is love, as 1 John 4:7 declares. For those who love are born of God and know him, because he is our beloved love evermore. So let all revealed children of love now understand that when Christ returns unto his temple in Jerusalem, as the book of Malachi foretold, that he shall also arise in the overflowing glory of his very own majesty of love everlastingly. And when he comes forth in the shiniest resplendence of his most illuminated honor, he shall come in a manner of a covey of doves. He'll come in a manner of a covey of doves, with the crown of doves surrounding him. And he shall then walk upon the heaven's vaults with the sign of his sickle of Amos 9's love, leading his revealed cross of love, unconditional, that he has long bore in secret. But now it is finally revealed. And upon that soon coming day of Emmanuel's physical return. The whole world, in the meantime, can behold him like the sun of love shining from the east unto the west. And hosts of hosts shall surround him evermore within their whitest feathery wings, most lovingly embracing him as they carry his most fiery chariot unto earth with the greatest flames of their passion, all lighting their way of peace as that prince thereof comes forth on the great white cloud of his kingdom. And then shall he cause the lame to walk, the deaf to hear, and the dumb to speak, as even the blind all will come to see through his blinding light that shall remove all cataracts of faith and remove all double-mindedness. And he will then multiply his most loving and merciful signs as wonders of peacefulness to behold. So blessed are the obedient, who will believe love's kingdom has finally come, as it is written, for they shall behold heaven and earth being made anew, as God finally does a new thing, as Isaiah 43 foretold. And as they receive their thrones of glory for their love's awaiting crowns, such wise souls will gird on the blessed breastplate of Yahweh, and they shall then be given power to bring life where only the walking dead once stood ever so faithlessly, as they grew roots into their couches as if they were only potatoes of do nothing nature. It's time to quit being couch potatoes and learn that love is an action word. It is a verb. If love is not in action, it is dead. So, but it has it's already come to pass. When his everlasting kingdom age new covenant was first given by me unto all of mankind, that after the Lord banished Satan and the war in heaven was over, that he then sent humanity watchers of his love who will aid all of our course by those hosts coming forth with their own overflowing love to impart into us if we will receive it. Therefore, all over the circle of his earth, our Lord God Almighty then dispatched troops of love's finest, most radiant glory unto the east, as he then sent forth 64,000 heavenly seraphim, and unto the west he sent 64,000 cherubim, and unto the south another 64,000 Ophanim angels, and another 64,000 messenger angels were sent to the north. And some had six wings, some had four, others had two, and yet all were united by their fast fluttering wings of the whitest white. And it was therefore destined that their rustling noise of those wings would become as praise glorifying our risen hero of heroes, and that the sound of its blessedness were then even moving both heaven and earth. And it came to pass then, as that wondrous activity was happening, then Gabriel and Uriel, they became brilliant pillars of love's shiniest light, as Michael the archangel burned as an inferno of kingdom age hope that all children of love's obedience could behold. For all believers in love's most precious peace shall be given to eat at the manifesting tree of life. They shall be given to eat of it. And it is now growing upon the Lord's holy mountain of God's overflowing passion at this channel for all followers of his kingdom age truths herein. For as his love's hottest passion flows, it can now begin consuming sinners and devils alike as but stubble. And it shall come to pass that hearers of God's kingdom age word of love here at this channel will dissolve in his presence like ice dissolved by fire, and thereby shall the religious perish like deflated serpents with no breaths left in them as they become spiritual people of love's laws of kindness that shall become their religion. And that will all bring much glory unto our Lamb of Love who is risen and who is the good shepherd over all the flocks of men. And this is his one world religion of John 10:15. And he shall be the good shepherd over all the flocks of man. So blessed are believers of his love, for with the eyes of their hearts they may now behold him arising upon his most stupendous glory that shall inspire our most furious passion of love for that majesty of majesties as he appears as flashing lightning across his sky, and his fiery chariots will be with him. Faster than a leopard are his great white horses, and much bolder than wolves are his messengers, Trudy and Daniel, whose family crest is that of a wolf holding Satan's severed hand. Great is the stature of Emmanuel, who shall soon be God with us once again, exactly as it is foretold. So behold now with the eyes of your heart and mind our Ancient of Days, arising as our hero of heroes. His stature is great and high as he floats over the highest mountains, equal to the clouds in the sky. And as the obedient behold the splendor of Christ's magnificence, the beneficence thereof shall be awe-inspiring, and they shall desire him to come as the desire of all nations, as they will spread that amazement unto all other people, all other nations and languages, free of copyright, translate away people, to all people dwelling upon the earth's circle. For this kingdom age everlasting gospel of his love is mighty in his wonders and revelation as his everlasting kingdom comes forth. And then God's voice suddenly roared from the great beyond, and his roaring lion of Zion came from Jerusalem as he said this. He said, behold, verily, verily, these videos of Daniel and Trudy are the leaves of my two olive trees for the healing of the nations, and they come from they who are my two chosen candlesticks. Behold, two olives of the spirit of hope arise, says the Lord, and the wise shall see them in their dreams, and they shall arise strong as their height reaches heaven in the sight of all the earth, and their leaves shall be fair, and their fruit thereof much, and in them there shall be meat for all. Under their shade all may rest, as my whitest doves of love fills their branches unto overflowing. And people, it is time to get with the program. And the program is here. And the program is one that by the time this kingdom age is over, as the blessing of the voice of Aaron Neville is singing, the heavens above will be here on earth, and the kingdom age will just explode the fullness thereof. Every man will have a chicken soup in his pot. Every man will have a pot. Every man will have a home. That is what's prophesied, and I know how to make it happen if anybody would ever give me the time of the day. I'm just the messenger being ignored that I'm responsible for stirring up enough love in this loveless world that the overflowing love will save every one of our butts. Good thing for that.